accounting for nearly a third of all forested land in the world, boreal forests are a vital ecosystem for the planet. They stretch from Scandinavia to Russia, all the way to here in Canada's east. They attract less media attention than the Amazon, but boreal forests are also in danger, threatened by climate change. Here in Quebec, rising temperatures have made the forest more vulnerable. An insect infestation decimated the trees 10 years ago. Now, only their skeletons remain.
T'as l'impression quasiment que c'est une forêt qui a brûlé. Tellement les chicots sont secs.
Yann Boulanger and David Perret are among the Canadian researchers who study the forest closely.
C'est comme si une bombe avait explosé, donc tous les arbres sont morts. C'est un insecte qui est très, très virulent, qui va manger toutes les aiguilles, qui va même manger les feuillus, les feuilles des feuillus. Donc le dommage est très important. Il y a des pattes
ici, ici. The culprit is this insect known as the hemlock looper.
Donc si on a un exemple d'un piège qui a récolté de l'arpenteuse, la pruche.
In the northern regions, home to boreal forests, temperatures are rising 2 to 3 times faster than the planet as a whole. These increasingly mild temperatures are allowing eggs to survive the winter.
Quand on pense au changement climatique, on pense aux sécheresses, on pense aux canicules, mais il y a des changements qui se produisent l'hiver et qui sont importants pour l'écosystème. Donc, on craint ici qu'avec des hivers plus cléments, on ait plus souvent des infestations comme celle-ci.
Further west, in northern Alberta, the forest has also been ravaged, this time by fire. In May 2016, a huge blaze devastated the town of Fort McMurray and the surrounding area. It was the costliest natural disaster in Canadian history. Nearly 90,000 residents had to flee. Among them was Harvey Sykes.
All that you see there, that's all burnt, and the fire actually came about to where we're standing.
Up there, where you see that high hill there?
When I was younger, we used to go out forest fire fighting, Dave. And so I know what fires can do and what they're like. And you know, this one was a monster.
You see the flames, and there was walls of smoke coming, and all you do is turn and run. That's all you can do.
Monster fires like the one Sykes experienced are increasingly frequent in Canada, but also in Alaska and Siberia. Since the beginning of the century, 70% of the land consumed in fires was in boreal forests.
On se retrouve avec une saison de qu'on appelle une saison de feu qui est plus longue, plus sévère. Où justement les feux peuvent survenir sur peuvent être plus intenses, couvrir de plus grandes superficies. Et c'est d'ailleurs ce qu'on observe justement à l'échelle du Canada.
Boreal forests are home to some of the most ecologically intact areas on the planet, and they are rich in natural resources. But their exploitation poses yet another threat. In Canada, logging represents an important part of the economy. And in the west of the country, the world's biggest oil sands production complex sits in the middle of the forest. Gaping holes have been opened between the trees in search of the black gold. Canada has 10% of the world's oil reserves, much of it found in oil sands like these in Athabasca. Every day, 3 million barrels of oil are extracted from the sands, helping to make the country the fourth largest oil producer in the world. Since the opening of the first oil sands mine here in 1967, the sector has grown rapidly. And it has had a direct impact on the way of life of the indigenous communities present in the territory for hundreds of years.
I feel sorrow for Mother Earth's gifts to us are being poisoned. This is our territory that is all being desecrated by the oil industry for the sake of the dollar, money, prosperity, as they call it. I lost my prosperity when the industry came in and took over all our lands and our waters and our access to our wildlife, our medicinal plants and everything that we depend on to sustain our culture.
In the middle of it all sits the small town of Fort McKay. Most of the residents here are First Nations people, like Jean Lomcor, or Métis, of mixed European and Indigenous descent. And they largely depend on the oil industry, whether directly or indirectly.
The reality is if they shut off the oil sands tomorrow, my community would starve.
Many have reached financial agreements with the oil industry, something Lomcor finds hard to understand.
You can even see the tar sand on the ground. It's like you can't bite the hand that feeds you, pretty much is what they're thinking, but like they don't feed me, I feed myself.
While some areas have been protected, in other places entire sections of forest have disappeared. In their place are now roads, factories and giant ponds dug out to collect toxic water. The oil sands sector, which accounts for 12% of Canada's greenhouse gas emissions, touts efforts to mitigate the effects on exploited land. But none of this will be enough. Rising temperatures are changing the entire landscape. Research models show the forest is being forced north, and climate change is going faster than the trees' ability to colonize new terrain.
Definitely worried. I think when I started doing this work, we did some models, and I kind of remember like doing those first models, like, oh, that must be wrong. I thought it was just wrong because it was just so extreme. And then other people started kind of reinforcing and having similar models, and it's kind of like such an extreme rapid shift.
Researchers are now scrambling to find ways to protect this crucial ecosystem. Because what happens in the boreal forest has a decisive impact on the globe's northern oceans and overall climate. Covering 10% of the planet's land surface, boreal forests store and purify an incredible amount of fresh water. And they hold twice as much carbon as all tropical forests combined.